فتح السيسي held a meeting on Saturday with Presidential Advisor for Urban Planning General Amir Sayed Ahmed, the head of the Armed Forces Engineering Authority General Ihab Al-Far, and a number of senior officials. Presidential spokesperson Ambassador Bassam Radi said the meeting discussed the construction situation of a number of projects held by the Engineering Authority all over Egypt, including several projects in the new administrative capital, particularly the Strategic Command Center and the designs of Misr Mosque. The meeting also reviewed the restoration and renovation works of a number of shrines downtown Cairo, taking into consideration their architectural trends and preserving their spiritual and historic patterns. Radi also said the head of state gave his directives to resume efforts to develop and raise the efficiency of roads and access nationwide. The president was briefed on the latest developments of the new car city as he instructed the executives to build a global car city, which includes exhibitions, parks for new and used cars, as well as maintenance centers equipped with the latest technologies in this field. Also on Saturday, President Abdel Fattah Sisi held a meeting with Prime Minister Dr. Mustafa Madbouly, Minister of Irrigation and Water Resources Dr. Muhammad Abdel Ati, and Minister of Agriculture Dr. Sayed Al-Qasir, as well as the head of the Armed Forces Engineering Authority, Lieutenant General Ihab Al-Far. Presidential spokesperson Ambassador Bassam Radi said the meeting tackled the best ways of benefiting from flood waters in the irrigation of some crops, as well as the national project of seeds production. The head of state was briefed on the latest developments of the joint projects held by the Ministries of Irrigation and Agriculture to make the maximum usage of rains and floods waters, particularly in Sinai and the North Coast, as well as several Red Sea areas. The meeting tackled efforts exerted to reach this goal by renovating and raising the efficiency of old wells, building dams, the smart storage of seasonal rainwaters to be used in cultivating valleys and natural fields. The president directed the ministers to resume coordinated efforts among different concerned bodies to develop the agricultural sector and to guarantee the reasonable use of water from different resources, coinciding with lining canals to reach the best results. Minister of Defense and Military Production, the General Commander of the Armed Forces, Lieutenant General Mohammed Zaki, witnessed the final stage of the joint Bright Star 2021 military exercises, which were held in Egypt with the participation of 21 countries. Details.
The multinational two-week-long military exercise Bright Star 2021 hosted by Egypt was wrapped up as the final phase of the drill was attended by Defense Minister Lieutenant General Mohammed Zaki, Army Chief of Staff Lieutenant General Mohammed Farid, as well as leaders of the main branches and senior commanders of the Egyptian Army. The drill kicked off on September 2nd at Mohammed Naguib Military Base in the Northern Military Region with the participation of 20 countries, including Egypt and the United States. Armed Forces spokesperson Colonel Gharib Abdel Hafez said the defense minister conveyed the greetings of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, the supreme commander of the armed forces, to all 20 friendly and brotherly countries taking part in the exercise. He also praised the participating forces' outstanding performance and their ability to undertake joint tasks in a professional way after making the best use of expertise transfer. The final phase of the drill's activities included a tactical live-fire shooting project with the participation of the various troops taking part in the drill. The exercise also included training activities on first aid and field medical evacuation of injured elements. The Bright Star drill is one of the most important joint training activities the General Command of the Egyptian Armed Forces is keen to implement in order to strengthen military relations between Egypt and many Arab and foreign countries, exchange expertise, and develop the leaders' and officers' skills.
Algerians on Saturday mourned the passing of former President Abdelaziz Bouteflika, who died aging 84.